Hey, Medfash, it is the 3rd of January, 2020, and I thought this was very interesting in light of all the anti-Semitism that we've been seeing as of late, that they would have this gathering at a couple of locations, but primarily at the MetLife Center Stadium there in New Jersey. More than 92,000 Jewish men and women congregated to celebrate the reading of the Talmud. Now, very briefly, because I need to do a more comprehensive video on this, and I probably won't post it here, but I will absolutely let you guys know. They've already gone through and pulled I don't know how many videos out of my channel. So 92,000 Jews gathered. I mean, that's just pretty amazing, wouldn't you say? The 2,711-page Babylonian Talmud, which is the very book that they will interpret the Noahide laws through. And if you're so inclined, you want to go look through the Babylonian Talmud, you're going to find some pretty interesting things in there. Things that you might not agree with, but on the surface, it's going to sound like the greatest thing ever to implement these moral laws to take care of the planet and bring peace and harmony into the world, right? Okay.
I have the great opportunity, and I'm very humbled, to share with you some of the words that my dear Rebbe wrote 32 years ago that is so relevant today. And the Rebbe writes about the power of the United Nations. All of you here have been given by God an opportunity to make a difference in the world. God gave seven laws called the Noahide laws. This is the bedrock of any civilization that were to exist. And the Rebbe pleaded, if only the United Nations will go back to the basics and empower their nation to adopt the seven Noahide laws, then this world would be a very different world. So I ask every nation that's here, everyone that's listening, consider taking the seven Noahide laws back to the basics and apply it to real daily life.
You want to believe that men, especially these men, are going to do that, you go right ahead. But there's way too much tied into this, and it ties into so many other things. But like I said, I want to do a thorough video, and I can't do it here. I just can't. But I can show you this. You know, this cycle of Babylon Talmud reading began in 1923 on what? September 11th. Now, don't you think that's just, like, really interesting, coincidental, that this gigantor gathering that they're having here just happened to begin 96 years, 3 months, and 22 days ago to the day from the day of its first cycle beginning on September 11th, 1923, mind you? And this ties into Purim, which the Book of Esther, I mean, it's an interesting thing, you guys. There's some things being revealed here that I really got to pray on and study because this is pretty deep. But I would encourage you, if you're so inclined, to go look into what the Babylonian Talmud says. Not just about Jesus or Yeshua, his mother was a whore. You know, other than those things, that's only the surface. So I'm looking at this gigantic gathering here, this coincidental gigantic gathering where all this anti-Semitism just happens to be flaring up just as this gathering happens, was nothing more than a massive dragon serpent conjuring ritual. And you got to remember, only the top of these groups know what's really going on. The overwhelming majority of them are largely deceived, and they need our prayers that they come to the truth. I mean, even the governor was at this thing.
The governor came out to show his support for the event and the Jewish community.
We rise and fall as one family, and we will stand strong.
Telling these 92,000 Jews that we'll do everything to protect our Jewish friends as their own cities are just decimated. It's unbelievable, you guys. But I just at least wanted to get this out to you. I'll leave some links if you want to check into these things. God bless you all. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,